this Jupiter meditation, we will try to be in harmony with our world, so our actions are in perfect alignment. For that, we need two energy centers to function optimally. The third chakra, which is in front of our stomachs, and the sixth chakra. The reason for this is that the third chakra is our chakra of action. It allows us to act in a way which is good and natural to us. The sixth chakra gives us understanding of the effects of our actions, of the time and place we find ourselves in. And this combination of being able to act and having a very good situational awareness allows us to be successful and to seize the opportunities around us. Enjoy the meditation. First, go with your attention to your belly. And start by focusing on your first chakra, the base of your spine. And allow it to open so your spirit is well connected to your form. Next, we will open the second chakra. You can visualize it as the petals of a flower unfurling themselves. To open the chakra of desire. Connect these two chakras so that the red base chakra and the orange second chakra are in harmony and balance with each other. Next, we move up to the third chakra. Yellow stomach chakra, allow that to open as well, making your set of bottom chakras complete, so that the three of them together form your center of will and action, from which all things are derived. The action should not merely be what we want, it should also be what is correct. And for this we will need sensitivity, guidance and awareness. So next, open up the heart chakra, so that we can be connected to the environment, to all the people and things and energy flows around us. Your heart chakra is like your radar, opening your eyes to the world around you in all its depth. We will activate our throat chakra, which is all about predictive models. have a model of the entirety of society in there, of how to manipulate things, and how to respond to people communicating with us, manipulating us. Allow this knowledge to bloom. Now we have to bring it all together. And bringing our attention to our third eye. Open up that chakra without rushing into thought, but being merely conscious of you and your environment. The flow of energy, movements, of actions around you. Feel that you're part of a current of events. Cause and effect, cause and effect. An unending chain. It's also that you're not a powerless piece of driftwood in this current. By the power of your will, you can navigate this current. Move where you want to go, using the laws of cause and effect. Using the opportunities and finding the branches which carry you off in other directions. Open the sixth chakra wider. Let this vision of where you are and what possible futures lie ahead of you becomes more clear. Now we are reaching as far as we can, as humanly possible, in our understanding of the world around us.
Yeah.
Now we have to take one step beyond, to align ourselves with the power of the planet, which in itself is also aligning us with the world around us, uniting our consciousness with our reality. Think of Jupiter and open your crown chakra to receive the Jupiter impulse. There are holy places which are devoted to the chief of the gods, the father of the gods, different types of religions, but the energy is virtually the same, regardless of the religion. It is the power of the benevolent guide, who protects its children, who cares for them, who loves them, the loving universe around us, welcoming us, supporting us. Do not shy away from this power. You are not its slave or its servant, but you are its child. And just like a child, be curious, be willful, so that your parent may respond to you. Show your desire, who you are, what you want to do, what you feel you need to be able to move forward. And try to feel in which regard your personal desires match with the guidance you are receiving from Jupiter. See if you can make the two match, because maybe it is not time for certain things to be manifested yet. Those desires will just lead to frustration and pain. Find what is on offer in the universe around you, the present time. You will see that some desires are very difficult to fulfill, while others are very easy to fulfill. By choosing a path of success, you can bring happiness to you and your loved one. Allow your spirit to cooperate with the divine guidance in creating a perfect alignment between your desire and the world around you. So that you will end up desiring what is granted to you. So no opportunity of the universe will be wasted. You will blossom, you will grow, being nurtured by a loving universe. Feel that the universe is welcoming you to shine, to be yourself, to follow your own path, that there is a way prepared for you, a place is prepared for you in the world. Allow yourself to step into that place without fear, without self-judgment, without doubt. Because no longer we are blind and struggling against the flow. Now we are being guided how to navigate and set a course in our lives. Thank thanks to the authority of Jupiter. We can show our desire, and people will know that this is not just our desire, but also the desire of the benevolent universe, for Jupiter himself. They can respond to it by not going into personal conflict, but by accepting both you and the will of the universe. Successful people generally have a very strong Jupiter aspect. Not all of us are granted such a blessing upon our birth. Many of us have to struggle, have to fight to achieve anything, while others are born lucky. By working with the power of Jupiter over and over, your attunement to this power can improve. Thereby, your luck can improve. But remember, it is also the will of the universe to support. So all the blessings and success you receive also be passed on to help others move forward on their paths, to be successful in reaching their goals. For this is what it means to be aligned with Jupiter, not just to receive, but just as much to give. Be aligned with the power of benevolence. Feel free to stay in this state as long as you like, and go back to it regularly before you have to make an important decision.